Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to the webinar. Thank you so much for joining us in today's session. Today is the last session of our Canada series. I hope you all enjoyed our Canada session. Let me start with a quick round of introduction. My name is Asif Bhatt. I am part of the PTE India team. I will be your moderator for today's session. I'm excited to introduce you to our guest speaker for the session, Ms. Megha Srivastava. She's the Senior Recruitment Advisor for India Region at York University. Welcome, Megha, to the session.
Hi, Asif. Thank you so much. I hope you and your family are keeping safe. And a big hello to all the young minds that are joining us from across South Asia. I'm really looking forward to the interaction today. So thank you so much again for giving me and York this opportunity to be a part of this wonderful conclave.
Thanks, Megha. So let's get started. Without further ado, we will open the webinar now. So could you please tell us about the York University and its locations? Why should students select the York University?
Absolutely, Asif. York is one of the leading public research universities of Canada. We have close to about 55,000 students across our two campuses in Toronto, which makes us the third largest university in Canada. With more than 10,000 international students from 174 countries, we are also one of the most multicultural and diverse universities in the entire region. And when we talk about programs, we offer more than 200 programs across a range of subject areas through our different faculties. Now, why students should choose York? Let me tell you that York is extremely popular with international students, especially from India, who have been choosing York because of its location advantage, because of the career-connected education that we provide, because of the fact that we offer a wide range of academic programs and there's a lot of flexibility in the academic offerings. Because of the fact that we have a very diverse and vibrant student community, and also because of the excellent student support services that we offer.
All right. You mentioned that York has two campuses in Toronto. Could you please tell us more about your campuses and the facilities?
Yes, please. So York has two campuses in Toronto. One is our Keele campus that you can see on the screen right now. The other one is our smaller campus, Glendon. Both these campuses, Asif, are interconnected with each other through a free bus shuttle service. And also, both these campuses are easily accessible by public transport and also by our own vehicle. Now, on your screen right now, you can see a very quick glimpse of our Keele campus, which is our big, beautiful, modern campus, extremely safe, very welcoming to students. It's like a mini city in itself. It's got 90 plus academic buildings. It's got 8 residences, more than 50 restaurants, a shopping mall of its own, all facilities related to athletics, related to health, they're all there on the single campus. So that's one of the reasons why we call it like a mini city, because you have everything that you need to live and study here. Another very important feature about this particular campus is that it's got two subway stations located right on the campus, which makes the movement of the students super convenient and super easy. Now, let me also quickly talk about our other campus, which is the Glendon campus, which you can see on your screen right now. It's our smaller campus. It's at a distance of close to about 25 minutes from the Keele campus. A very unique point about this particular campus is that it's our bilingual campus. So students take up courses in both English and French on this particular campus. And sometimes you also see students taking up courses in a third language. This has close to about 3,000 students. And often and on, we are always asked what makes Glendon so unique. So I would say the bilingual advantage that students get when they're on this particular campus, which comes very handy when you're looking for employment opportunities in Canada. This particular campus also provides more experiential learning opportunities for students along with a very rich and personalized student experience. Something which is very important to note about this particular campus is that the number of students per class starting from the first year is anywhere between 25 to 30 only. So you get more personalized support from your faculty. Last but not the least, it is a very multicultural campus. It has students from across 100 countries on this particular small campus. This might be our smaller campus, but then with a very big heart.
Such a great place to live and continue your education overseas. What makes Toronto such a popular city with the international students? Why is it so popular with the student community?
Absolutely. So I think the biggest advantage that York has is the location, because both our campuses are in Toronto. And in my tenure as a recruitment officer, whenever I've interacted with a student from South Asia and I've asked them, okay, where exactly do you want to go to Canada? 90% of the time, Asif, it's Toronto. So what makes it so unique? The largest city of Canada, one of the most multicultural and cosmopolitan cities in the whole world. International students love Toronto because there is so much to do. So if you're into food, there are so many restaurants, cafes, coffee shops that are serving you cuisines from all across the globe. If you're someone who's into sports, this is the city to be in. If you're an arts enthusiast, so many cultural festivals and performing art events happen all across the year. Or if you're a nature lover like me, there are so many hiking trails and walking trails that you can discover, that too within the city itself. Apart from all these things, Toronto is also the business and financial hub of Canada. So you would see that every major corporate has its headquarters located in the city, which creates numerous work opportunities for international students. Toronto, again, is a very warm, welcoming, multicultural city, which international students really like. And last but not the least, has a very strong Indian community, which never makes you feel away from home.
Thanks, Megha. Megha, what are the programs that York offer at the undergrad level?
So, Asif, that's a very good question, because a university is predominantly known by its faculty and the courses that we offer. So at the earlier part of, you know, our interaction, I've mentioned that we offer more than 200 programs in a variety of subject areas across our 11 different faculties, which you can see on the screen right now. So we have courses related to arts, media, performance, design. You have engineering, you have computer science, you have programs related to environmental studies, life and physical sciences, courses related to biology, some very unique programs like space engineering. We are the only university in the entire Canada to offer a space engineering program, and also psychology. When we talk about psychology, we are ranked number 6th in Canada for our psychology program. So it's impossible for me to kind of like list down all the 200 programs right now on this interaction, but do visit our website and you're going to also get the entire list there. And after this presentation, I'm going to share some links in the chat box, which is one of the tools is a program search that through which you can navigate through all our respective programs at York.
Good to know that. I mean, York University is offering such a range of course programs across different fields. So what are the unique advantages that York Academic Program provides to these students?
Asif, that's a very important point that you brought about. And this is something that, you know, we often outline to students when we are interacting with them. So I think the number one advantage that students have in respect to our academic programs is the wide range of programs that we offer, which we've already spoken about. Another thing is the flexibility. Now you can design your degree your own way. And what do we mean by that? So with most of the programs, the students can do a double major, they can do a major and a minor combination. And sometimes you can always combine two different subject areas together. So that's something that the students are really looking forward to. And that flexibility is the biggest USP of our academic programs. Another advantage that our programs offer are the range of practical hands-on learning opportunities that come along with our programs in the form of co-ops, internships, and placements, which again add a lot of leverage, you know, to their academic experience and also their work experience while they're there studying at York.
Megha, how does York University prepare its students for career courses?
So, I think you're asking me all the right questions now because you're asking me all the strengths that York is known for. So we are known as one of those universities that are very much dedicated in terms of preparing their, you know, its students for not only, you know, helping them prepare for their respective careers, but also ensuring that they are successful in their careers. We have a dedicated career center that assists students not only during the 4 years of their studies at York, but up to 2 years, you know, after they graduate from York. And this particular career center provides a series of services. So right from helping you prepare your resume in the Canadian style to organizing a lot of career development workshops for you, from organizing career fairs and networking events, you know, on the campus, to helping you with your job hunt or helping you with your internship opportunities. You know, this career center does it all. One of the very interesting programs that the career center has is that it collaborates very closely with the York alumni. And one of the one program that I really like is their Connect program, wherein they kind of like get the York alumni to take the students out for a meal, wherein they talk to the current undergrad students about the professional development. They talk to them about the upcoming careers in Canada. So this particular unit is extremely dedicated and it ensures that it is preparing students for career success.
Oh, thanks. Do you have on-campus residence facilities for international students?
Absolutely, Asif, we do. Like I mentioned, we are the third largest university in the entire Canada, and we do have on-campus accommodation options available for our international students. Every year, close to about 4,000 students stay on the campus across our 10 residence buildings that are located in both Keele and Glendon campuses that we have. On the screen right now, you can see a glimpse of the kind of rooms that we have. But let me tell you that our residences are in a traditional style. They are in the form of single sharing and double sharing rooms with common washrooms and common lounge areas. We highly encourage our incoming undergrad students to stay on the campus for the first year, because, you know, it's convenient for you. They are able to immerse in the university experience much better. But at the same time, because a lot of students ask us, is it mandatory for us to stay on the campus for the first year? It's not mandatory. It's just that York recommends you so that you have an overall university experience. Another very important thing to note here is that the residence is guaranteed for the incoming international undergrad students, at least for the first year, provided that you're filling up the application in time. So that comes as a big relief, especially to the undergrad students and their parents if they're looking out for accommodation options at York.
Megha, my next question is about the admission process. How can international students apply at York University for undergrad programs?
Absolutely. Another very important question. And just to kind of like simplify the answer, there are two ways of applying at York, Asif. One is through our own internal application, which is the York internal application. The other one is through the Ontario University Application Center. Now, if you're a student who wants to apply only at York, and trust me, there are a lot of students like that. So if you're someone who's going to apply, who's looking at only at York, then we definitely encourage you to use our internal application. And if you're a student who's looking at applying to you know, not only York, but also along with York, a couple of other institutions in Ontario, then you can apply through the OUAC application. This is a common app for Ontario universities. And if you're looking at applying to maybe three or more institutions, this works out to be a better option. So if you need more information about the application process, the forms and everything, all the information is there on the website. And after this interaction that we have, I'm going to also be posting a link about our application process in the chat window.
Yeah. Could you please talk about the admission requirements? And do you also accept PTE score for matching English proficiency?
Absolutely. So when we talk about the admission requirements, let's just talk about the broader requirements, because like I said, that we have 200 plus academic programs. It's impossible for us to get into every program and talk about the admission requirements for every program in the limited time that we have. So when we are talking about national curriculum that consists of, you know, your state boards, CBSE, ICSE, then we are looking at an academic average of 60% and above for most of our programs. Of course, there are a few programs that require a higher percentage. So if you're looking for a program related to BBA, computer science, engineering, there you require a higher academic average of anywhere between 70 going up to 85%. Now, similarly for IB, for most of our program, we are looking at a grade score of 28 to 30. But again, for the programs that I just listed sometime back, so computer science, engineering, BBA, BCom, you know, these are programs again for which we are looking at a grade score of, you know, anywhere between 30 to 36. For British curriculum, it's going to be minimum 2 A levels at a minimum grade of C for most of the programs. Again, for these specific programs, the grades would vary anywhere between B to A. So as you can see that there are variations according to the respective programs. Also, please note that every program would also have a set of preset course requirements. So for example, when we are talking about a program in engineering, apart from the fact that you've got an academic average of 75%, York's admission office would like to see whether you had maths, physics, chemistry in your grade 12 or not. Similarly, if you were looking at a program at Commerce, it's good that you've got a 70% and above academic average. But if you do not have maths, that becomes a bit of an issue. So it's very important to check the academic requirements course-wise on our website. And I would be also sharing a link for that. There is also a category of courses like the BBA, our social work program, our design program, and our program in fine arts that require an additional supplementary application. So a supplementary application would be an additional application that the student would have to fill up in order to kind of like successfully get assessed for these programs. Specifically, it consists of a leadership portfolio. It would consist of a video interview. It would consist of a timed writing exercise. Only when you have successfully submitted that particular supplementary application is when you can gain admission into these programs. Your question about PTE, we do accept PTE academic scores, you know, to match the English proficiency requirements that we have. So if you have a score of 60 and above in PTE, you know, we should be able to kind of like acknowledge that and you can meet the EP requirements at York with that.
Just to reiterate that, I mean, we are accepted inside Canada under the non-STS category. Yes, so PTE is accepted for Canada visas if you file your visas through non-STS category. Megha, does your York University also provide scholarships to the international students?
Absolutely, we do, Asif. We have scholarships ranging anywhere between $2,000 Canadian going up to $35,000 Canadian per year for international students. We divide our scholarships into two categories. One is our automatic entrance scholarships. The other category are our application-based scholarships. Now, when we talk about the automatic entrance scholarships, these are scholarships that would range anywhere between $2,000 to $3,000 Canadian. These scholarships don't require an application to be filled up. and they are restricted to programs offered by the Faculty of Liberal Arts, Faculty of Science, and the Lausanne School of Engineering. This is, the process is very straightforward if you've got an 80% and above. And also, if you file your application in time, you should automatically get these scholarships reflected in your offer. Now, talking about the second category of scholarships, which are application-based, apart from applying to York, you would have to fill up an additional application to get these scholarships. And these are extremely competitive scholarships that range from anywhere from $5,000 Canadian going up to $35,000 Canadian. You need a rock star profile for it, Asif. You need strong academic scores. You need a very strong co-curricular profile. And the most important thing is that you need to be nominated by your high school. And your school can nominate only one student per award. So it is definitely competitive. But then if you're a student who thinks that, yes, I have it in me, and I want to apply for these scholarships, please go ahead and apply for these scholarships. The application-based scholarships at York come with a very firm deadline. They open up by the first week of December and they shut down by the end of January. So it's very, very important that you follow the timelines and apply in time for these scholarships.
Thanks, Megha. Bright minds will always find a way to get a hold on these scholarships.
Absolutely.
Please tell us about the fee structure of York University for undergrad programs.
Absolutely, Asif. So there you go. On the screen right now, you can see a very clear breakdown of our tuition fee. We've also given you some estimates about your personal expenses, your estimated expenses for the meals. So I would say for most of our programs, the fee is anywhere close to about $32,500 Canadian. It's only for the engineering programs that the fee is close to about $37,000 Canadian. Now, if you look at the estimated total cost, it varies anywhere between $50,000 to $55,000 Canadian.
Thank you, Megha. Thank you so much for such an insightful information about the York University. We will now open the session for the questions. And please, if you have questions, please put your questions in the Q&A box, or you can put that in the chat box. All right, Megha, we have received some questions here, so I'm going to read those questions for you. Okay, there's a question from Pratusha. I hope I got the pronunciation right here. Is it possible to apply at York University through PTE overall score of 56 and not less than 53? And the best course for PG diploma? I mean, he wants to know about the best course that you're offering for PG diploma.
So Pratusha, this particular session is restricted to answering questions about only undergrad because we do not have our graduate team with us. We do offer postgrad certificates at York through our School of Continuing Studies. And I can always share the contact details with you. You can always reach out to them and find out more. And your question about PTE, we do accept PTE, but you'll have to also reach out to them to ask. Like for undergrad programs, if you've got a PTE score of 60 and above, that's what we look at. You'll have to really check as to what is the kind of score that they require for a PG diploma. But then we do have some PG diploma certificates. Unfortunately, I deal with only undergrad programs, so my knowledge is limited in this particular respect.
Thanks, Megha. The next question is from Sangeeta. Which course do you suggest for high school graduates in sociology without maths in grade 11 and grade 12?
So I would say when it comes to, sociology, we anyways have a very robust program in sociology. We have a four-year undergrad degree in sociology, so you can go and explore that. If you're specifically asking for that particular program, that's definitely there. Plus, we have like 200 plus programs that we offer at York. So what I'm going to just do is that I'm just going to, just enter some details in the chat box, so that you guys can have a look at it. We've got this excellent tool, which we call the program search. And you can always go through that and to determine that whether it's sociology or whether it's something related to psychology that you want to do, all your interest lies towards social work, because these are questions that depends on where your interest lies, you know. So I'm just gonna type it in the chat box and you can just make a note of it. And this goes out for all the students, you know, who are there in the session, because sometimes we have just one question that does York offer this program, or what are the kind of options do we have? Just use this program search and you will get answers to all your questions in that regard.
Thanks, Megha, for sharing the program list in the chat box. So the next one is, what is your acceptance rate? What is the acceptance rate when students apply at York University?
So that's a very tough question. And trust me, my admission office doesn't even share that information with me. I know that we are a very competitive university. As you know, that when you're selecting your university in Canada, York is always amongst the top five institutions that you're going to select to file an application. If you're going to look through our admission requirements, you would see that these are pretty structured and, you know, not very high as well. My disclaimer to the students in this regard is that it doesn't mean that if you're saying that we require 70%, that if you've got a 70%, you're going to get into York. It is just to kind of like give you an idea that, yes, you're eligible to apply. The tip that I can share with all of you here, because I do not know the acceptance rate, but I can just share the tip that apply as soon as you make up your mind that you want to go to York, and apply as soon as the intakes open up. So for example, if you're a student who's looking at the fall 2022 intake, ensure that you have everything sorted in your head by September this year, because applications open almost a year before. The sooner you apply, the better it is, because that's the time when the faculties have their seats open. That's the time where I would say that they are assessing applications. And the later that you apply, it's going to be difficult for you, because by that time, the applications are already jammed into the system.
Okay, the next one is from Sukrit. I have 91.5% in non-medical stream, want to do computer engineering related courses. Kindly advise me the course in your university and the fees too.
So Sukrit, the course that you're looking for, we have that particular course. It's offered by the Lausanne School of Engineering, which is one of the most prestigious engineering and computer science faculties in Canada. Your scores are great. So let me congratulate you for getting that particular score. So you can definitely look at the computer engineering program at York. What you need to kind of like pay attention to is that if you've got your results, you know, this particular year, you'll have to really check whether the courses are still open for the winter intake. So I'll take the opportunity to kind of like highlight that York has three intakes. So we have a fall intake, we have a winter intake, we also have a spring intake. However, for the Jan intake, our number of courses that we offer and the number of seats that we have are lesser than what we offer in the fall intake. So if you're going to just give me a second, Sukrit, I'm going to just fetch some information for you for the computer science program, and just going to post it, computer engineering program, my apologies. And I'm just going to post this in the chat box. Just have a look at this particular link. And if you have any kind of further questions to that, I'll also be sharing my email ID. Do get in touch with us and, you know, we can guide you accordingly, because during the session today, we have limited time. So I'm just posting the link. Sukrit, just make a note of it and do get in touch with me on the email if you have further questions.
Sure. Sukrit would also like to know, when is the last date for the applications for engineering course?
So Sukrit, that's a very interesting question, because it's an online application. Like I said, the sooner you apply, the better it is. The last deadline for most of our programs, we've been told at time stretches till the end of October. But please know that's not the case with all the programs, because, you know, programs have an online application. And while you and I are interacting on this platform right now, there could be a student who's applying to the program at the same time. So though the deadlines are till the end of October, we always advise students to apply as soon as they can.
The next question is, can we get admission in psychology course without maths?
Yes, absolutely. So the psychology program that we have, we offer both a BA in psychology and we also offer a BSc in psychology. When we talk about the BA in psychology, it doesn't have a maths requirement. So if you're a student from the humanities stream, or if you're a student who's taken up commerce and you do not have maths, this is the best option that you have. So if you have a query about the BA in psychology, just the way I shared the information for the computer engineering program, let me also pull out the information for you for psychology. And what I was advising Sukrit, that, you know, go through this information. And if you have any follow-up questions, I would love to speak to you. You will have my email ID, so you can always drop in your questions to me as well. So here you go. Just make a note of the link in the chat box. That'll take you to the program website for the psychology program.
Thanks, Megha. The next question is from Pankaj. Yep. What course York University offers for international students related to biology?
Related to biology?
Yes.
Yeah. So we are very strong with programs related to biology. These are offered by our Faculty of Science. So we do have a BSc in biology. We offer programs related to biomedical. We even have biotechnology, biochemistry, biophysics. So these are the top five programs that we have. And, you know, we definitely, like the way I shared it for the other programs, I'm going to also take a second and I'm going to share the link with you in the chat box to check out our biology related programs. Because, you know, every university has certain programs which are very, very strong. So when it comes to York, the bio-related programs that we have, our psychology program, our BBA program, our BCom program, our programs related to computer science and engineering, these are our strengths. So if you're looking for anything related to biology, and when you're going to do a thorough research, I'm sure you're going to have York in your list of institutions. And while I said that, I've also posted the link for the biology program in the chat box for you.
The next question is, can students defer their course program if the visa decision isn't available for the intended semester?
Absolutely, you can. And I think with most of the Canadian universities, you can do that. It's just that you have to do it, according to the deadlines that are there. So for example, in the case of York, there's a proper application that you need to fill up. If you want to defer your admission from one intake to the other intake, just to give you an example, like there were students who defer their intake from the fall to the winter intake, and they had to kind of like fill up everything by the mid of August. There could be certain scenarios wherein we can accept special requests if your visa has not come in, maybe by the 15th of August, but then that's treated case to case. But there is a deferral application that you need to fill up, and that's very much possible at York.
Thanks, Megha. The next question is from Asmita. Do we have to send PTE score for getting the admission offer from the York University?
See, Asmita, when it comes to admissions into York, there are two things that you have to make note of: your academic scores and your EP scores. So if you've sent your academic scores and you've not sent your PTE scores, you're going to get a conditional offer. So it's always advisable to, and you don't have to send us these scores. You can upload that on the portal. And with most of the EP tests that we accept, you have to make a request, from the organizers of these particular tests. They usually send the scores directly to the respective institutions. So you don't have to kind of like send that to us through an email. Either you upload it on the portal or you request, the PTE to kind of like send your scores directly. And it's a very structured process, so you don't actually have to worry about it.
Yeah. So another question on psychology from Manjeet. Can we apply after post-graduation in psychology?
Manjeet, I would like to understand, like, if you're looking for an undergrad program in psychology, we would definitely advise that you apply after the high school. If you've already done a postgrad program, it doesn't make sense for you to you know, apply for a program at the undergrad. I know whether I'm getting your question correct. Or if your question is about whether we have a postgrad option in psychology, that's something that, again, I'm not aware of because that's dealt with another team. We do have a range of master's programs, but most of these programs are research-based. So towards the end, I'm going to share my email ID, and I'm also going to share the email IDs of some of my colleagues who are taking care of graduate admissions, and you can reach out to them. But for an undergrad program, preferably, you know, if you're a high school student, you know, that would be the profile that we kind of like look at. If you have some gap after your high school, we don't mind till the time you kind of like justify that particular gap to us, because there could be a lot many reasons which are very valid. And York is a very accommodating institution. If they feel that you had a reasonable reason, you know, that there was a gap in your studies after the high school, we would definitely acknowledge it. So that's a different process wherein you would have to give us all the documentation and, you know, reasons in written as to why there's a gap. But if you've already done a postgrad program, doing an undergrad program after that, it actually doesn't make sense. And also from a visa perspective, might not be the right path to take.
Megha, do you have the courses that don't require mathematics in business-related programs?
Oh, yes, we do. So we have this excellent program, which is called Business and Society, which is offered by the Faculty of Liberal Arts. It doesn't have a requirement for maths. It's a program which is the need of the hour, and it's extremely popular. It basically kind of like assesses the effect of businesses on the society. So that doesn't have a maths requirement. So that is one program that the students can look at if they're looking for a business program and they're looking for a program that doesn't have a maths requirement.
Thanks, Megha. The next question is from Pankaj. What about campus placements after completing the undergrad or postgraduate degree?
So Pankaj, if you were a part of the presentation that, you know, we were doing, so the concept of, let me just first clear out that concept of campus placement, that term is something that's been coined, I believe, in India, because none of the, you know, overseas universities have this term called guaranteed campus placements, because that's what it sounds like. We have a very dedicated career center, Pankaj, and I, you know, did speak about it a bit, you know, while me and Asif were talking about it. And that particular center is, you know, dedicating all its efforts, you know, to ensure that the students are preparing for a career and also succeeding at that particular career. So it offers a range of services. So it even starts before it starts, you know, giving you the job listing. So right from preparing your resume in the Canadian style to kind of like organizing career development workshops, you know, for you guys, from organizing career fairs, from organizing networking events, and then also, you know, making you aware about the job listing. So, you know, there would be job opportunities out there and you would see them listed on the portal of the Career Center. Pankaj, nothing is served on the platter. You know, when I look back, I realize that I had to work so hard to get my first job. But if you are someone who believes in hard work and you are dedicated, Canada is a land of opportunities. And with our Career Center, they would tell you the opportunities that are there. But you would have to work hard, go and grab them, you know, by your own efforts and hard work.
Thanks, Megha. Another question we have is, do you have any maths bridging programs for business-related programs?
That's a very good question, because this is something that York has very recently introduced, because we do understand that, and I was a commerce student and I was forced to take maths. And I know that when students in India are, you know, picking up streams, there is a significant portion of students who do not take maths. So what we have, Asif, you know, especially for our programs related to commerce, economics, we have this qualifying year program, which is like a 1-year bridging program wherein For example, I want to apply for a bachelor's of commerce program and I do not have maths. I would get entry into the qualification year. So I would study certain modules that would bridge the gap for mathematics. And I would study the modules related to the first year of commerce. Once I successfully complete the qualification year, then I get to the second year of BCom. So how it's beneficial for the student, because you're actually not wasting any time. You are doing the bridging program, which is integrated in your main program itself. And that's a very recent feature that we've added at York. And it is valid for programs that are offered by the Faculty of Liberal Arts. So like I said, that if you're looking for a commerce program or you're looking for, an economics program or a business economics program, this particular qualification year program is definitely there.
Thanks, Megha. Megha, could you also tell us more about the study / work program of York, under which students can find paid on-campus employment opportunities at the undergrad level?
Thanks, Asif. And, so Pankaj asked me a question about, the placement. So Pankaj, to kind of like reinstate the fact that how seriously we take the career development of our students, we have this very dedicated study work program at York, which only focuses on providing employment. And let me just repeat that, paid employment opportunities to our undergrad students. And what are the kind of opportunities that are there for these students who are studying undergrad under this particular program that we have? So you can take up any kind of administrative, logistical related, clerical, technical types of jobs within the faculty and your respective departments. You can become an international student ambassador. You can become a global peer mentor. You can be an international student recruitment officer. These are, again, positions that are specifically designed, under our study work program. And these are all paid positions. Another very interesting opportunity under this particular program is doing paid research projects with certain faculty members. Now, this is something that comes really, really handy for students from the Lausanne School of Engineering or the Faculty of Science. And every year, close to about 2,000 to 2,500 job opportunities get created under this program that we have. Apart from that, Asif, if you remember when we were talking about our Kiel campus and I was mentioning it as a mini city, there are 50 plus restaurants on the campus. There's a shopping mall of its own that the campus has. There's libraries, there are computer labs. All these places require students to come and take up positions. So there are ample of part-time job opportunities that are available under the study work program and also at various facilities that we have at York.
The next question that we have is, what makes Canada the top study destination?
I think the most important question, I think, for me, because Canada is a destination which is one of the top leading destinations, for international students. And Asif, I feel that there's plenty to love about Canada. Talking from a student's perspective, I would say the outstanding quality of education, right from the elementary school going up to post-secondary institutions. The fact that Canada is ranked number one for the quality of life. I think as an international student, because I've been an international student myself, the country is extremely warm, friendly. It welcomes you with open arms. Something which is so important, for an international student, because remember, you're moving out of your comfort zone. That you've grown into, throughout your life. So that's something which is very important. As a parent, I have an 8-year-old daughter. When I'm selecting a university, my priority would always be safety. So when it comes to Canada, we are one of the safest countries in the whole world. And not only the urban centers, but also the small towns. Talking about the cost of living and tuition, it's very competitive when you compare it to other English-speaking countries. Last but not the least, something that that attracts me to Canada a lot is the natural beauty. You have wonders like the Niagara Falls, you have the Northern Lights, you have the Lake Superior. It's a beautiful place to stay, to work, to study, you know, for international students. It offers you an experience like no other destination would.
Also, Megha, availability of part-time jobs is another reason that attracts international students to Canada.
Absolutely, Asif. And adding to your point, which is a very important point, Canada also has the friendliest immigration policies, you know, currently. So thanks for pointing that out. And all this and more makes Canada the leading destination for international students. And we are very proud of it.
Does York University provide students with part-time job opportunities on campus also, or do they have to look out for campus for such opportunities?
So there are opportunities on the campus, which we discussed, you know, during one of the last questions that you asked, and they're ample. Like I told you that, you know, under the study work program that we discussed in detail to going to opportunities on the campus, you know, there are a lot of opportunities on the campus itself. And then we are talking about Toronto. We are talking about a city which is the most multicultural and cosmopolitan cities in the whole world, a city that is the financial hub. So there are ample opportunities for students if they don't want to come work on the campus and they want to work off the campus. Toronto offers them that as well. So being at York, they have this dual advantage that if they want a job on the campus, there are a lot of options to explore. And if they're looking for options outside the campus, then sky is the limit because Toronto offers them that.
Thanks, Megha. Any special initiatives that York has taken to support students during the unprecedented COVID times?
I would say as a leading public research university, ensuring that the entire transition from in-person to online, you know, ensuring that it was smooth and working towards it, investing so much in the technology, ensuring that, you know, we are taking our students and parents along. I think that has been one of our major initiatives that we've taken. At the same time, you know, maintaining that constant line of communication, because Asif, as you know, that this has been like one of the most challenging times that we've all seen, whether professionally or personally. And, you know, there's been so much of anxiety and we ensure that, you know, we are connected with our students, we are connected with our parents, you know, whether through our communication platforms or whether through one-to-one Zoom meetings. That was another initiative that York very seriously worked at. We were also one of the first universities to get the COVID readiness plan in place so that if a student has a valid study permit, he can easily travel to, you know, York. Also, another very important thing, and this is in respect, you know, to the exam cancellations in India. So again, very few Canadian universities came together and we decided to waive off the admission requirements mentioned on the conditional offer letters of the students because of the delays that were caused, you know, for the results to come out or, you know, because the examinations were getting canceled. Now that provided a lot of relief to the Indian students because everybody was kind of like really worried about that under the new assessment scheme, what's going to happen to my grade? So for example, you're a grade 12 student and your exams got canceled and under the new assessment scheme, you got lower than what your predicted scores were. You didn't actually have to worry about your offer at York because till the time you got the conditional offer, we were honoring your conditional offer. So I think that was one of the steps that we took and it was widely appreciated. The last but not the least, we have some additional support for our international undergrad students who got a visa refusal. So if you're a international student, you applied for your visa for, you know, and you had applied for a program at York, you got a visa refusal. We are offering additional support. You can fix up a meeting with our immigration office who would help you to file another application with their support. If you get a visa refusal the second time after the team has assisted you, there's a possibility for you to request for a full refund. You know, so that's another initiative, Asif, I just wanted to kind of like outline, because I feel that this is the time when institutions have to come together and offer support and assistance to the students and parents, because these are really challenging times. And we do understand what you're going through, and as an institution, we are doing whatever we can in our capacity to support you.
Yeah, that is such a great initiative that you guys have taken. The next question is from Parag. Industry orientation, interface, R&D and projects. Okay, there's a question before this. What kind of industry orientation, interface and project work you have to make it highly competitive and pragmatic with R&D? So this question is more centric towards R&D and projects.
Yeah, so I would say that when it comes to not only York, but most of the Canadian universities, one of the biggest highlight of our programs is that we pay a lot of attention to the research component. So that is something that you're going to start doing research projects starting from the first year onwards, you know, because, you know, when it comes to our curriculum in India, you would see that there, you know, most of the times, we don't know how to do a research, or we don't know how to kind of like do even proper referencing. So that's definitely a part of our programs. And like I said, not only restricted to York, but then every Canadian university is very, very particular about it. And you would start having workshops specifically with the faculty that are going to focus on teaching you how to conduct the research. What are the tools that you use? How effectively can you do that? So, it kind of like also conveys the seriousness that the faculties, you know, and the university has. And I believe that the research component is very, very important, because that's also a component that makes you learn more about a particular subject area. So even if you look beyond the undergrad courses that Canada offers, and that's one of the reasons why most of the master's programs that are offered in Canada are all research-based. Because you become so strong with that particular component, you know, at your undergrad, that you're so clear what you want to do in your master's level. And the universities are very confident that, okay, you've done the undergrad, you understand the research. So you have more and more options to choose from masters. And these are all research-based master's programs that most of us offer in Canada. So you find very few taught programs at the master's level, and more of research-based programs in Canada at the undergrad.
The next question is, how are the student applications assessed in Canadian universities, academic versus extracurricular?
It's a very good question. I would say most of the times, you know, academically, even at York, for example, for most of our applications, we pay attention only and only to your academic scores, and we also want to see a consistency in your scores from grade 10 to 12. There are, however, few programs, you know, and I think I had highlighted some of those, like, you know, the BBA program, or if you're looking at our design program or our fine arts programs, that is where you are required to fill up a supplementary application. So you're supposed to present a leadership profile, you're supposed to go through an interview. So I would say very much restricted to the academic assessment. And yes, you know, with an exception to some programs wherein we do pay a lot of attention to your co-curriculars, it also differs from institution to institution. So my answer would be restricted to how York is assessing its applications. Also note that your extracurricular activities might come very handy when you're applying for the application-based scholarships at York, because there, if you spoke about, you know, when I was speaking to you about, you know, our application-based scholarships that range from 5,000 going up to $35,000 Canadian, there one of the major components of your application is going to be your extracurricular profile.
Okay, the next one is from Sandeep. What type of courses I should choose after plus two?
Sandeep, so I would say, maybe one of the days when you're in a good mood, sit down with a pen and a paper and list down areas that you really like or things that you like to do. Because Sandeep, to be very honest, it's a question, you know, and the answer to that particular question lies within you. me, Asif, or anyone, even if you go to the one of the best universities in Canada and you are talking to the rep, cannot answer that question for you. Like I said, we have a range of programs that we offer. And like I, you know, like I mentioned earlier to you, it needs to come from within you. So if you're looking for anything related to business and commerce, we have that. If you're looking for something related to engineering and computer science, we have that. Health related programs, yes. You want to do something related to media, yes. So whatever you want under the sun, York has that. But then we would like to understand what is it that you want. So like I said, that answer is within you. And I'm sure you will be able to discover it very soon.
Okay, I don't see any more question in the chat box. But if you have any question, you can get in touch with the Mega. Mega, if you could just share your email address.
Yeah, I would. And I will also take the opportunity to kind of like, because there were a few questions about the master's programs also. Let me just see whether I can give you some information about, you know, that as well. I would be able to share some email IDs. So I'll just take a minute.
You can make a note of Mega's ID. It's now on the chat.
So I'm just going to copy paste some information for our postgrad programs, because I know that some of you did ask me questions about that. So here you go. Just make a note of it. You know, I've kind of like added respective web links, you know, for the postgrad programs along with the concerned colleagues that you can get in touch with. And I'm going to also, since I think my email ID has got hidden under this big message that I've just typed. So I'm going to just rewrite my email ID once more, which is megas7@yorku.ca. Please feel free to reach out. This has been your, maybe this must be your first interaction with York, but go through the information that we've provided you. Go on our website. I'm going to also very quickly share with you, you know, the details about our website. Go on our website. Explore a bit more about York and come back to us with any kind of questions that you have, and we would love to answer all your queries either through a Zoom call or either through the email, whichever works better for you.
One last question, Mega, I can pick from an anonymous user. Can we get admission in Jan intake if we fulfill requirements till September?
Yes, why not? You know, so I would say that it depends on the course that you're looking at. So for example, if you're looking at a program like computer science, let me tell you that it's completely full. But if you're looking for some programs under the Faculty of Liberal Arts, we're still accepting applications. So since it's an online based application, if you're applying to that program and your application is going through, that means that there is still availability of that program and you can still go ahead with your application. If it's, the program is not going to appear in the drop down menu, that means that that program is already over. But if you're looking for Jan, and if you're a student from CBSE or from ICSE or from the state boards, please remember that you've already got your results. Don't wait for your EP test scores. At least apply so that you can request for a conditional offer, because there are scenarios wherein you keep waiting for your EP test scores, and by that time you might miss the bus. So that's just one tip that I just wanted to share.
All right, that brings us to the end of this webinar. Thank you so much for such an amazing session. I hope all the participants enjoyed the session, and I hope you enjoyed our Canada series. Take care. Goodbye.
Thank you, Asif. I really enjoyed the interaction, and thanks for being such a great moderator, and thanks everyone for joining in. For any questions, feel free to reach to us. Till then, stay safe, stay indoors. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone. Bye.
Bye, guys.